Hello guys, my name is Arun and welcome to my channel. This series is a series of tutorials on scientific programming using Python. Now in the last tutorial, we saw how to do a simple integration in Python. Now along with that, what we did is that we just took a simple function f of x equals x, okay, or y equals x, and then we set the limits of x, and then we used the quadrature function in Python inside SciPy to integrate it, and we did this. We got this answer. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is that let me explain the same with a little more of a complicated example. Now what I'm going to do is that I have taken a little more of a complicated function. Okay, and then I'm going to integrate this today. Now what is this function? Is that this is actually this function actually comes from the Plancks Law. Which stay okay. Now I don't you guys don't get fuzzed up or really tense as to what's going on. Don't worry. I'll just explain this simple. See, every object okay you see around has its own temperature. It has a temperature greater than 0 Kelvin. Okay, if that being the case, what Planck says is that the object emits energy in the form of radiation throughout all the directions. Okay, now. What he says is that if you have a black body, meaning a body which emits energy in all wavelengths, it absorbs energy completely and emits energy completely, okay, then the energy emitted per second in joules, I mean per second per meter square per Kelvin and per micrometer of its wavelength, okay. Remember, energy is emitted in at all wavelengths, okay? Each wavelength has its own fast share of energy, okay? Okay, it is actually given by this complicated relation over here. This E lambda is actually given by this. What did this actually say is that, it just says, okay, we go to Wikipedia page, okay? This equation says that this is the amount of energy, okay? Or they call it the spectral radiance that is measured, or the spectral radiance which is actually the amount of energy. Given by his described by the amount of energy an object gives off as radiation of different frequencies of different wavelengths. Okay, its unit is per unit area per solid angle per frequency. Sometimes it can be represented in terms of per wavelength like this notation. I'm using the wavelength notation over here, and then what I also did is that I've just wavelength like this. Okay, but a small change is that in my formula I just included pi to indicate that, you know, here where is that, yeah, here it just measures the entire energy per solid angle as well. I mean, that's the entire angle around the object. If you want to remove the angle effect, multiply the equation with pi, and that's it. Okay, so this is the amount of energy you get, and there's a reason why I chose this. This is actually a very tricky function to integrate, a very hard function to integrate with normal methods. So you have to use quadrature methods to do that. And besides, this function has two arguments, two variables, lambda and t. Now what you're going to do is that during our integration, we're going to keep one of these variables as constants, and then integrate with the other one. So the entire code goes like this, and don't be scared, don't be afraid. I'll break this one by one step. Explain what's going on. Now this is the code. Okay, I'll just walk you guys through what's happening. Okay, here I just import the NumPy, and here is the quadrature module which you used last time. Okay, here what I did is that I've include from SciPy there is this. A dictionary. There's this collection class called as constants, which has another object called as codata. Okay. Now in that codata, I'm importing that. In that codata, there is something called as physical constants. Okay. Physical constant, which is actually a dictionary. So what I do is that I just extract the entire dictionary here D from it, entire physical constants dictionary into D, and if you look at D, okay. It's actually a dictionary with 399 entries, and if you look at it, it is a big collection of scientific constants, like something from angstrom star, which I've never heard of, to Avogadro constant, to Bohr magneton, to atomic mass unit, Thomson cross section, Stephen Boltzmann constant, Rydberg's constant, and you know, several stuff. You just have so many values in scientific constants between. So if you want to access it, don't worry, it's already available. Instead of writing it on your own, you can just access it directly from it. So that's what I've done. And this is the spectral function. Okay, what I've done is that you see this function on the top. I've expressed this over here, and HKD, these are the Planck's constant, okay, Planck's constant, Boltzmann constant, speed of light in vacuum, extracted from the dictionary over here. Extracted from the dictionary, and that is it. I'm using them in the function value, and that's it. I'm returning this function. And S is, okay, I don't need this anymore. Okay, S is nothing but Stephen Boltzmann gone, I don't need that anymore. And I define temperatures, and I kind of define two wavelengths. Okay, let me just set the wavelength. Okay, I'm set. Okay, so what I'm going to do today is that I'm going to integrate this function by keeping the temperature constant, and I'm going to integrate this between two wavelengths. Now if I've done that, okay, let me tell you what happened. If I do that, okay, they keep it the temperature, if they keep the sorry, I just forgot. This per Kelvin does not matter. The per Kelvin does not come. It's just watts per meter square per micrometer per steradian. You multiply by pi, the per goes on. So this is fine. Not per Kelvin, okay? Okay, so that's my typo. Sorry, that's a typo. Ignore about that. I'll correct it when I'll correct it before you guys love to learn. I'll just correct that. Okay, now what happens is that if I'll just explain what in a minute. Yeah, perfect. Okay, I'll explain what in a minute. What I'm going to do is that to this function, I'm going to keep the I'm just going to fill the value of temperature in, so that this entire thing becomes a single function, single variable function. Okay, and then if I integrate this function between two wavelengths, then I'm going to get the energy emitted in watts per meter square between a particular wavelength band. Okay. And okay, so for that I need to integrate this entire function by keeping temperature constant, but the integration is between wavelengths, between two values, limits between two values, and that's what I'm going to use over here. Okay, so int 1 comma r 1 equals squared of spectra between these two wavelengths. Okay, this line will keep the temperature to be constant in the spectra function, and then it's going to integrate the function between wavelengths 0.8 micrometers to 0.78 micrometers. Now there's a reason why I chose this. This actually stands for the violet wavelength. I mean, if you look at your the light, if you look at your visible light or your rainbow colors or your, okay, 0.38 micrometer corresponds approximately to your violet range, whereas 0.78 micrometer corresponds to your red wavelength. So integrating this function with keeping the temperature constant gives you an idea as to how much energy is emitted, okay, what is the total amount of energy emitted in the visible spectra. Okay, if you guys want to have a look at how this is how it will go by. This red region over here, this is the region with that is being under integration, like that. Okay, that's a simple way to look at. Okay, and then not only that, I'm setting T1, I mean, the catch is here, I'm setting this Rx to be T1. What I mean here is that, okay, I'm setting T1 to be to have a value 5770 Kelvin, and I'm telling to the function, okay, quad function, in the spectra function, keep the value T to be as an argument, and keep it to be T1, okay, whose value is given by this. Okay, now you might ask me, now, okay, I set T1 to be this value, and I set these to be the integration limits. Now, my question. If this being the case, how should I know that this entire integration takes place with respect to L or with respect to T? Well, the simple factors is the order in which the integration variables are introduced over here. Now, The variable that I mean, if you want to integrate the function with integrate the function with respect to L, keep L to be the first argument and keep the temperature T to be the second argument. If you want to integrate this function with respect to T, if you want respect to T, just change the order. Instead of L comma T, put it as T comma L and then proceed with it. Now the fact is, what if I just keep it like this and I were to change the argument like that? Well, that part is something tricky. I haven't figured out yet, but it's possible to figure out, so you can just check it out and it's not a problem. Okay, coming back, now what I do is that I just calculate S1, S2, S3, S4, which are actually the spectra values of for the given wavelength between 0 to 5 micron, micrometers. Don't worry about this, I'm just giving, so I'm just setting 4097 points in between them. That's not a big deal. Don't worry about it. Okay, I'm just setting between 0 to 5 micrometer. I'm just setting like 4097 points over here, and I'm going to get this function to be return values between with L and with constant T1, constant temperature. And similarly, yes, this will be S1, the spectral emission value, or the E lambda T value for all the wavelengths for the corresponding for a particular temperature T1, like that I do for T2, T3, T4, keeping L as constant. The total energy emitted by the object from all the wavelengths from all the way to 0 microns to come to the infinite microns is actually given by a simple approximate relation, simple relations, sigma T power 4. That's the total energy emitted by an object, by a black body. And that's about it. This is E1. So what I'm going to do is that after calculating this integral, the total energy flux that can be emitted by the body is given by E1. The energy flux that is emitted by the band between this wavelength range is given by E into 1, and the total energy flux fraction that is the energy emitted by this within this band to the total energy emitted in the entire spectra is given by this, so it's going to return a fraction. And then the error of the integration, the error of this integral value is given by ERR1, and that's it. And then these are just values to plot them in the function, plot them in the map, sorry, in the plot, give them a plot, spectra. This is nothing but this is to fill the lines, just like what we saw. Legend, grid, axis, ticks, and everything, just like what we saw in one of the previous tutorials. And nothing much. These are nothing but just titles, so figures and everything. So if I were to run this, it's going to take some time. And voila, there you have it. Now this is the energy. Now something important to note is that if you look at these values, okay, with increase in temperature, the total energy emitted by the object increases just greatly. So because the total, if you look at the total energy emission, it's actually in the fourth power of temperature. It's actually in the fourth power of temperature. Okay, as a consequence, it's actually in the fourth power of temperature. So as a consequence, okay, with increase in temperature, the amount of energy emitted by the object increases just remarkably. So if I were to jump this between 6 instead of 6000, okay, this is the value, okay, and there's a reason. There's a reason why I chose T to be 5770 Kelvin. That is actually the temperature of the sun, surface temperature of the sun. This is the surface temperature of the sun. That's the thing. And these are just values just to give a comparison. Nothing much. Okay, so if I were to run this, this is how I get. Now the thing is, now this is not the only form of integration that is available. You have other forms of integration available as well. Like if you go to SciPy integrate, okay, quad, you have this quadrature function, quadrature function. You have the you have an option for double integral, triple integral, n-dimensional integrals. Okay, fixed quadrature, I mean just normal adaptive quadrature, and a function which integrates ordinary differential equations, like this, and you have other Simpson's integration, Raumburg's integration, special integration, and several other stuff. Not only that, you have options to do special integration, I mean other type of integration as well, like trapezoidal cumulative integration and everything. You have options to do all this kind of stuff. So guys, just you can, if you guys want to do, you can go and explore. And if you guys want to do, suppose if you want to integrate it and find the resultant of a function as to how it looks like, okay, cumulative trapezoidal integration is very useful for that. Okay, this uses composite trapezoidal rule to do the integration. For an example, if you just look at this example over here, it just sets x to be one value, and function is y of x, and y of integral is actually integrate of y of x between y comma x. Now what it does is that since your function is y of x, your y equals x, so integral of this function y is actually x squared by 2. So if you integrate, so if you look at it, it becomes a parabola open upwards. So what is being done over here is that you have successive integration happening. With these values, and you're just plotting them over here, and that's about it. So you're just saying that the integration is coming nicely. Nothing much. Okay. Yes. So you're just showing that the integration is happening nicely. That's about it. Okay, like that, there are other integrations as well, so you guys have a look and you'll find it better. And if you guys go to the folder where we look at, if you go to the file explorer, the file we look at, you'll have the image over there, so have a look at it. Okay. That's all I have for you guys in this tutorial. Where is it? Yeah. Okay. Now in the next tutorial, we'll see how to make differentiation in Python. Okay. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.